Tombstones typically contain kind, loving words, like in memory of, here lies, rest in peace, those kind of messages. But there are some pretty dark and mysterious tombstones out there with unknown origins. These tombstones contain pretty creepy messages, from cryptic codes to references to the devil. Let's talk about this and more only in today's video. Hey everyone, what's up, and welcome back to Most Amazing Top 10. I'm your host, Lindsay Ivan, and today we'll be looking at the top 10 mysterious tombstones with unknown backstories. But before I go any further, I want to take a quick second to share with you guys a documentary that I just finished watching on Magellan TV. It's called A Shallow Grave. How fitting is that name for today's topic? Magellan TV is a membership streaming service filled with top quality and entertaining documentaries. They have over 3,000 titles to choose from, and they add new programs on a weekly basis, so there's always something for you to watch. It's the site that I go to watch all of my true crime documentaries, like the one I just mentioned. A Shallow Grave explores the disappearance of businessman Alec Steenkamp. On September 17th, 1996, Alec went missing after going to collect money from a man named Kenneth Downey. After being missing for a day, his wife contacted the police and filed a missing persons report. But here's the thing, the police never investigated. They didn't do their job. They interviewed the last person Alec was in contact with, Kenneth, and that was it. That was until 8 years later. A private investigator named Christian Booth was hired by Alec's daughter, Samantha, who didn't want her father's case to remain unsolved. And guess what? Without too many spoilers, the PI solved the case and found Alec. That's all I'm saying, you have to watch the rest to find out who did it. Now, what's great is that the shows are available in 4K without any additional fees and no ads or commercials. You can even stream it on a number of devices or even cast it from your phone to your TV to watch it on the big screen. If you're interested, go ahead and check the link in the description box for a 1 month free trial with Magellan TV. And they also have gift cards available if you love it and want to gift it to someone else. So if you're interested, check the link below to unlock Magellan's entire collection of documentaries. And now, let's continue on with the video. Starting off this countdown, we have John Reaney. In the churchyard of St. Mary's Priory Church in Southeast Wales, there lies a very odd tombstone. It's the tombstone for John Reaney. It features a series of letters in a grid-like pattern. Reading it from left to right just looks like gibberish. But this is actually a type of acrostic puzzle. Once you solve it, it spells out, "Here lies John Reaney." Underneath it, it says the typical stuff, like he died May 31st, 1832, he was 33 years old, blah 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 blah. But what a lot of people want to know is why John decided to have a coded message on his tomb. Well, one theory is that he was trying to fool or trap the devil to keep his soul safe. So this phrase can be read 46,000 different ways. This would confuse the devil and ensure that John got to the afterlife safely. But that's just a theory. Another theory is that John carved it himself just for fun, cause why not? You know, for a bit of entertainment in a dreary place. Moving on to number 9, we have the tombstone of Betty Stuyven. The message on Betty Stuyven's tombstone has confused residents for years. What does it mean? So the inscription reads, "Within these walls are deposited the bodies of Miss Betty Stuyven and her child. She was the beloved wife of Alex B. Stuyven to the end of his days, will deplore her death, which happened upon the 25th day of November 1783 in the 23rd year of her age. What was remarkable of her, she was a mother without knowing it, and a wife without letting her husband know it, except by her kind indulgences to him." So people are like, how is she a mother without knowing it? I mean, if you're pregnant, you know. But this is open to interpretation. One theory is that Betty was a slave and Alec Stuyven was her owner. Apparently she got ill and slipped into a coma for quite some time. During that time, he impregnated her and she gave birth to a child, who Alex gave away to other slaves to raise, which is just hella messed up. Another theory is that the engravers didn't mean the statement literally, and she was just a mother figure to all and acted like a wife to others because of how much she cared for them. Either way, people like to speculate, and we'll never truly know what this means. In our 8th spot today, we have the library paste. This next gravestone is pretty weird, I'm not gonna lie. It says, "Unknown man died eating library paste July 14th, 1908. It's also not a proper tombstone, so like, what's going on here? Well, let's look at the supposed backstory. Legend goes that in 1908, a man was wandering the streets of Goldfield looking for something to eat. He was rummaging through the trash outside of the library where he came across a jar of book paste. Being desperate, he decided to eat it. But that substance is very deadly, so it would have killed him, as the tombstone says. The people of the town eventually found him and decided to make a little makeshift grave for him. But here's the mysterious part. For being more than a century old, the red paint on the grave is very bright. By then, it should have been faded and chipping. So, was the story made up? Or do people return to his gravesite every so often to repaint the words so that no one forgets his story? Others believe it's just a local prank. Again, who really knows? In our 7th spot today, we have the Baby Monster. This next tombstone reads, Baby Monster, born October 23rd, 1888, died February 3rd, 1888, or 1889. It's hard to tell with its age. Either way, the mystery is, why doesn't this tomb have the child's name on it? One theory is that the kid was born with some sort of deformity. Back in the day, the word monster was used to describe someone or something that was out of the ordinary. So if the baby did have a birth defect, they sadly might have been called a monster, which is seriously messed up. Or maybe the baby was just never given a name? Honestly, we don't know. Either way, it's super sad and mysterious. In our 6th spot today, we have the werewolf. Are werewolves real? Or something we just feared from fairy tales? Well, this tombstone suggests that the deceased Catherine Cross was killed by human wolves. Human wolves? Could that mean werewolves? One theory is that Catherine was actually killed after an abortion gone wrong. They were extremely illegal at the time and also very dangerous. So human wolves would be a reference to the doctors that took her and her baby's life. What makes things even more mysterious is that in 2016, someone stole her headstone. We don't know why someone would do this or where they even put it. As of today, the headstone hasn't been replaced and is still missing. We are now at our 5th and halfway mark with the Turning Head Angel statue. Now, this statue is creepy and mysterious for a couple of reasons. The main one being, apparently it frickin' moves. You heard me. Apparently on a number of occasions, people have seen the statue's head turn and just look at them. So the story goes that on March 14th, 1908, a gas explosion took place in a drug company, and as a result, 5 female workers lost their lives. This statue was placed at their gravesite, which was marked by only their last names. Of course, having a big angel like that in the cemetery attracted a lot of attention. People who have visited the grave have claimed to see the statue's head move. However, it's said that it mainly turns its head to look at cars driving by, and a number of drivers have claimed to have seen this. So what's up? That's hella creepy. Some say it's the angel watching over the girls' graves, which you know is sweet, not that creepy anymore. In our 4th spot, we have the Victim of the Beast. Located in Salt Lake City Cemetery is a really terrifying gravestone for a woman named Lily E. Gray. The gravestone reads, Victim of the Beast 666. So immediately you're probably thinking what I'm thinking. Was this woman in contact with the devil? Did Satan himself kill her? Well, her obituary says that she died of natural causes. Well, there are 3 main theories out there. One is that Lily passed away in a car crash on Highway 666 through Utah. A lot of fatal accidents have taken place on that highway, and people believe that the devil has a play in that. Theory 2 is that Lily was a follower of Aleister Crowley. He often referred to himself as the Beast 666, so maybe he had some sort of play in her death. And the last theory is that her husband had that inscribed on her tomb. Her husband Elmer apparently had a criminal record and was all like, F the government. So maybe he blamed the government for Lily's death and was referring to the government as the Beast 666. But again, who knows? Moving on to number 3, we have the tomb of XYZ. Or Z. I don't know. Now, here's another mysterious tombstone that is associated with an urban legend. So, legend goes that one night a group of 4 robbers decided they were going to rob the Deep River Savings Bank. But the lead man ended up getting shot after trying to open one of the bank's windows. He died, and no one in the town identified him, so the town just buried him in a remote area. Shortly after the burial, a letter was sent asking for the grave to be marked only with the letters XYZ. No one knew who wrote the letter, but they claimed it was written by a female. Over the time, the mystery grew. Every year, people have said that they've seen a woman in black visit this mysterious grave. She would drop a small flower and then leave. People have seen this woman for 40 continuous years. Now, this is just a legend. We don't know if the backstory is even real. The mystery is, who is this guy Who is this woman, if the story's real, and what's the significance behind XYZ? In our second spot, we have the tomb underneath the porch. Just this year, a man in Toronto, Michael Killinger, was doing work on his property when he found a mysterious gravestone under his porch. The stone is hard to read, but he believes it says, "In memory of Isabella Hislop, or Bishop, wife of Amigo Hardwell or Bardwell, died November 24th, 1858. Now, the home's previous owner lived there for 40 years before him, but the gravestone has no connection to him. So Michael is determined to find out how the stone got there and who it belongs to. He believes that the stone might have come from a brickyard or garbage dump by accident. Or whoever lived at the house previously had Isabella's tombstone replaced. I mean, there was a big crack in this one, so maybe they replaced it and they took the old stone back with them and left it underneath the porch. But honestly, we can't be too sure. Michael has currently put the tombstone up on Craigslist. Don't worry, he's not selling it. He's just trying to find out more about Isabella and her stone. And in our number one spot today, we have the specimen. Located in a graveyard at the Ohio Asylum for the Insane is a really freaking scary tombstone that just reads specimens. In fact, there are two tombstones that read this. And the fact that this is in an insane asylum cemetery makes it way creepier. Like, what is buried there? People that were being experimented on? Animals that were being experimented on? Body parts? Nobody knows. But of course, there are so many theories. Not only that, but the asylum has a reputation for being haunted and for conducting unethical experiments on patients. Like back in the day, they did lobotomies there, as well as hydrotherapy and electric shock therapy, as well as drug experiments, which is what has led people to believe that everyone who died during these tests are buried in this single grave labeled as specimens. Alright guys, that's all the gravestones we'll be looking at today's video. Let me know in the comments below which one gave you the heebie-jeebies. With that being said, why don't you smash that like button and subscribe to Most Amazing Top 10 for more amazing videos. I've been your host, Lindsay Ivan, and I will see you when I see y'all.